The three wise monkeys are a Japanese pictorial maxim embodying the proverbial principle, see no evil, hear no evil, speak no evil. The three monkeys are Mizaru, who sees no evil, covering his eyes, Kikazaru, who hears no evil, covering his ears, and Iwazaru, who speaks no evil, covering his mouth. In simple words, the three mystic apes convey the meaning, seeking for evil, hauser of evil and spreading of evil is not meant to be done. Mahatma Gandhi had named them Bapu for Mizaru, Ketan for Kikazaru and Bandar for Iwazaru when a monk had gifted him these figurines. As being the occasion of Mahatma Gandhi's birthday, let us discuss more about his ideologies on the three monkeys. Mahatma Gandhi, being a man and fan of truth, emphasized that giving out an expression of fakeness was a sin. In today's world of technology, injustice and simulation, what could be the fourth monkey? There are many problems, basic problems faced by mankind. From the time of dinosaurs to the time of online course, few supported negativity and many took benefit of the act that still supported the negativity from the perspective of truth. On a frank note, if a problem takes place, how many of us blame, from the politician to the people who have been affected? Think. So, the possible fourth monkey would support no negativity. Some wise people told me, when you point out someone else, be careful, the other three fingers point out you. I say you. Good afternoon, everyone. I think this happened because of the people in between the report of course of action and screening of the instance. We can't blame them because when any problem occurs, instead of contributing for solution, we tend to stand ready to fight. In this scenario, we are unable to support people with the solution, or in other words, we are directed to do so by people who benefit from it. Too often, our reaction seeing or experiencing a negative or unfavorable behavior is to do one of two things, ignore it or complain about it. These are natural reactions, yet they are decidedly counterproductive. To make an impact or enact change, you have to take action and educate people. Call out the negative actions when you see them, but remember that criticism isn't taking action. You need to educate people on how to transform negative behavior in a very positive way. If you hear someone speaking negatively, don't participate in the conversation. You have two choices in this situation. You can either step up and try to reframe the conversation, or you can try to change the conversation altogether. It's all too tempting to be part of the group, to participate just because everyone else is doing it. Take a stand against negativity and make your voice heard. You can't create change by staying silent. Have conversations that address any negativity behaviors in your witnesses. Question: why we are allowing those negative behaviors to happen in the first place? If you observe negative behavior, chances are that you aren't the only one who is experiencing that negative behavior. So, collect members, a group of voices create a wave, and many voices produce a tsunami. Fight as much as people you can. There are strength in numbers. I hope that are from our ancestors, monkeys. Let us understand. Basically, we are truthful and value for humanity more than anything else in this world. We can bring a change in our family and surround us. Of course, I sincerely do not want to give a false hope by saying that we can bring change in society, mankind, etc. But one sentence, for cleaning a stagnant water, we can't move a pool. At last, it is inevitable to say Mahatma Gandhi's ideologies, which was far ahead of its time. For instance, you must be the change which you wish to see in the world. Thank you.